السلام عليكم سر.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته مغفرته حياته
السلام عليكم سر.
وعليكم
গুড মর্নিং
السلام
স্যার।
সবাইকে
আসসালামু আলাইকুম।
ওয়ালাইকুম আসসালাম সবাইকে শুভ সকাল। 13 জন জয়েন
জি স্যার।
করছে, আমরা শুরু করতে চাচ্ছি।
জি স্যার।
ওকে স্যার।
বিসমিল্লাহির রহমান রহিম। আসসালামু আলাইকুম।
ওয়ালাইকুম আসসালাম।
ডিয়ার লার্নার্স, I welcome you all joined with my virtual class. Hope you are well, safe and sound, especially during this COVID-19 pandemic situation. Hopefully, you will try to stay active and attentive throughout my whole session. My details, not to deliver further. This is School of Business, Bangladesh Open University. Our course is business ethics. Today's topic, manager ethics. Today's learning objectives or outcomes, changing values of management, approaches to manager ethics, rights and obligations of management, factors of managerial unethical practices, status of manager ethics, parties affected by management decisions, ways to ethical managerial decisions, manager code of ethics, managerial ethics in Islam, and then to be summed up. What do we mean by managerial ethics? Managerial ethics is a set of principles and rules dictated by upper management that direct a lower manager's decisions. I repeat it once again, manager ethics is a set of principles and rules dictated by upper management that define what is right and what is wrong in an organization. It is the guideline that helps direct a lower manager's decisions in the scope of his or her job when a conflict of values is presented. Examples: Dan is the production manager for a printing company. Taku Junction, one of their best customers, placed an order for 5,000 menus to be delivered on the first of the month. Dan just found that the order will be delayed by 1 week because someone on team ordered the wrong paper. Dan has a conflict. Should he call Taku Junction and explain what really happened, or should he lie or shift the blame to the paper supplier, claiming they sent the wrong paper? Dan surely doesn't want to lose Taku Junction as a customer, and they are not going to be happy about the delay. Luckily for Dan, his company has a clearly defined set of managerial ethics that covers situations like this. This policy is simple: don't lie, period. Even if they lose the customer, it is preferable to losing their values. Dan knows his company will back him if he calls and tells the truth, even if it results in a loss of business. And Dan picks up the phone and makes the call, hoping for the best and knowing he is doing the right thing. Now, our topic is changing values of management. The motivation and behavior of practicing managers are affected by value system. A common ideology is the basis for legitimating the organization as a social system. The managerial concept that guide the actions of the participants are the primary unseen networks that hold the organization together and make it a functioning entity. They are prime determinants of management practices. Above all, it should be emphasized that modern business executives are not guided by a universal or monistic ethic. Rather, they are guided by contemporary ethical pluralism, which provides general guidelines for decision making. There have been significant changes in the capitalistic ideology and in society's views of legitimate role of the manager and the corporation. Heilbronner summarizes this change in, is the concept of a new capitalism distinguished its sense of professional responsibility characterized by large-scale technological units imbued with a concern for human values and an aware of the legitimacy of labor and government as centers of economic powers. We have an expression, however, incomplete of what capitalism means that is markedly different from what it meant to the late 19th or early 20th century. Big businessmen and considerably different from the lingering conservative depiction today. Frederick Taylor's scientific management cannot be considered as an isolated force, but should be viewed in the light of the industrial and social situation within which is developed. Of Elton Mao, emulationists reflect a substantial evolution in management ideologies. Different styles of leadership that is authoritarian, democratic, participative, free reign, consultative work with different set of bad manager ethics find different treatment. While leadership style changes, balancing conflicts values for managerial decisions. Balancing conflicting values for managerial decisions. Some of the conflicting values which managers have to balance in making decisions are the following. Social, based on group and institutional needs. Economic, based on market values determined by supply and demand. Psychological, based on personal needs of individuals. Technical, based on physical factors, science and logic. Ethical, based on what is right. Political, based on general welfare needs of the state. Aesthetic, based on beauty. Spiritual, based on what God has revealed. Domain of managerial ethics, how the organization treats its employees, hiring and firing, privacy, wages and working conditions, how the organization treats economic agents, customers, competitors, unions, stockholders, suppliers, dealers, how employees treat the organizations, conflicts of interest, honesty and expense, accounts, and secrecy. Dear learners, now the topic is approaches to managerial ethics. When focusing on ethical position, entrepreneurs should analyze various organizational characteristics. One study examined ethical norms, motives, goals, orientation toward law and strategy for three distinct types of management. Immoral management, amoral management, and moral management. First of all, what is meant by immoral management? Immoral management is that kind of management in which managers practices unethical practices, that is wrong practices. Amoral management is that type of management in which managers remains neutral, whether they practice good things, ethical, and sometimes they remain neutral. And moral management. The moral management is that type of management in which managers always try to practice ethical practices and ethical issues, always try to follow right ethical issues using principles and rules practiced by corporate level or management. Summary of each characteristic within each of the ethical tab. These characteristics are important for gaining insight into the continuum of behaviors that can be exhibited. Before entrepreneurs set forth any strategy, it is imperative they analyze their own reactions to these characteristics and thus their own ethical styles. Moving from an immoral or amoral position to a moral position requires a great deal of personal effort. Whether it is a commitment to sending employees to training seminars on business ethics, establishing codes of conduct, exhibiting tighter organizational controls, the entrepreneur needs to develop particular areas around which a strategy can be formulated. Unethical practices requiring manager attention. Business practices which do not conform to rules of ethics are unethical practices. Illustrations of such practices include categories like seeking preferential treatment through lavish entertainment, pollution in contract bidding, underbidding with substitution of workmanship or materials, misleading and exaggerated advertisement, kickback to the purchase department employees, obscene and demoralizing advertisement, undercutting, payoff to government officials, price rigging between supplier and contractor, varying prices through favoritism and unfair canvassing, etc. A recent survey of 2000 major US corporations, 1990, revealed that the following ethical problems arranged in order of importance concerned managers. Number one, drug and alcohol abuse. Number two, employee theft, discrimination in hiring position, hiring and promotion, misuse of proprietary information, abuse of company expense accounts, plant closing, and layoffs, conflicts of interest, quality control issues, misuse of company assets, and environmental pollution. In other survey of 300 companies in 1987, management identified the top ethical problems as follows: employee conflicts of interest, inappropriate gift, sexual harassment, and unauthorized problems. Dear learners, rights and obligations of management. The obligation to manage gives rise to the right to manage. To put it another way, the basic authority of the manager arises from his functions. This is true even in case where the manager is the sole owner. His property right may give him control over various things, but it does not give him authority over workers, their time and energies. He obtains his later rights by means of the work contract, which binds the employees to cooperate for the good of the business in return for definite benefits. A manager does have the right to use the business as a personal toy, even though he has the power to subordinate the good of business to his personal profit or whim. He does not have the right or authority to do so. Management authority is limited by the clear rights of workers, stockholders, suppliers, dealers, and the community at large. Since most of these rights are relative, the line is not always clear, but it is there somewhere under the smoke and haze. As a result, the ethical manager must constantly be asking himself if his act is a reasonable interference with another's search for even useful goods. In short, there is a suspicion that what people fear is not management authority by management power, which is not checked by an institutional framework providing for both bilateral decisions and due process. Hence arises the need for manager ethics in the discharge of managerial functions. Now, factors of managerial unethical practices. Unethical practices are more likely when businesses focus solely on profit and intense competition. When top management gives lip service only to ethical behavior and fails to establish clear policies and adequate controls, and when their intensive to the customer's best interest and public concerns about ethics. Factors of questionable, unethical business decisions. Questionable business decisions often become unethical. Such type of business decisions are usually taken by the managers because of various factors. Some of these important factors that lead to questionable practices in business are, number one, intense competition between firms, departments, or individuals. Management concern for the letter of the law rather than the spirit. Ambiguous policies that employees interpret as window dressing for the outsider rather than clear expectation for ethical behavior. Inadequate controls. So that expediency and indifference to the customer's best interest. Management failure to comprehend the public's ethical concerns. Custom lets the buyer behavior and a groupthink mentality that fosters group decision that individual members would not countenance. Overemphasis on both individual and firm performance. Mission statements, evaluation systems, and organizational culture that focus on profit as the organization's sole objective.